Hey, it's Salty. Let's talk about this Delbert Ealy 245 Gyuto. It's 245 millimeters long, edge length, 56 millimeters high at the heel. The handle is about 145. The weight's about 210. It's deceived. The weight is deceiving. The blade is substantial, the dimensions are substantial, but the width is very thin. 2 millimeters at the handle. Tapers slightly halfway, and then tapers considerably after that. So this is a thin blade. So that 210 grams that this weighs, the blade isn't taking up that much of the weight. As a matter of fact, if you look at the balance point on this knife, the handle is taking up more of the weight than the blade itself. And the reason for that is, as opposed to a traditional Japanese wa-style handle, this one has a full tang, the entire length and width of the knife, which adds considerable weight to it. So when you pick it up in your hand, it feels heavy, but it really isn't, because most of the weight is centered right there. So that makes it very comfortable to handle. Also, this WAV handle is not traditional, not only because it's split and then attached, because of the contours in the bottom of the handle. Traditionally, they are straight, and they might contour and flare out slightly. This one's got little finger grooves in there, which I really appreciate. If you put it in your hand, if you notice, here's your groove, and it just kind of works really nicely in your hand. I had 3 Gyutos to choose from. I picked each one up, felt each one, felt them in my hand, and for some reason, this one felt the best. Whether it be the density of the wood, the particular qualities of this particular grind or whatever, but this one did feel the best. The Damascus is attractive. I put an edge on it. I did a tomato, did an onion, and a little bit of a little better view of the knife that I'll include in this video. And so far I'm impressed. Del, you've done a nice job with this, and I hope to see how it goes in the long run.